Guys, we are back with Adelaide while she's doing her vampire training to become stronger. Currently, while Kat is away, Adelaide is doing some meditation. Little does she know, as punishment for her little stunt that she pulled by invading the Stroud family. Losing to Jade is that Luella has been kidnapped. Unfortunately, Adelaide, who has lost all contact with the outside world other than Kat while she's doing her training, it looks like Douglas knows Kat as well, but Adelaide doesn't know that. But unfortunately, neither does Cornelius. He is still in complete hibernation. So, will Adelaide find out? Will Kat find out and be able to relay it to Adelaide? But what will come of it? Will it mean that before she's ready, Adelaide will need to face the Stroud family? After already getting her first victory from Marcos Davenport, she is retrieving training from Kat. They are now friends. She's a prime vampire. She's still got quite a way to go. Their training is not complete, but when Kat returns, we shall see what exactly she has in plan for Adelaide. Currently she's meditating, but while meditating, Adelaide Shaw found it in her heart to forgive Rosita Cresswell. Rosita Cresswell, of course, is the fiance of her brother. So, it appears that Adelaide has forgiven Rosita, but she has yet to forgive her brother. Only then may they be considered to help in this war. Maybe one day Adelaide may find a cure. Or cure's not the right word, because I wouldn't say that being a vampire is a disease. But find a way to revert a vampire into a sim. And perhaps she'll help her brother and Rosita be happy. We shall see. But for now, Rosita has been forgiven. It's 9 p.m. It's coming of night time. So, if you stop meditating, something crazy is going down in the room. When, no, Douglas, she hasn't forgiven you. She's forgiven Rosita. But Adelaide's gonna do some reading, go out to feed, and then hopefully Kat will be back to do some more training. Let's see if we can do a quick scope of where Kat may be, if she's in the neighbourhood. We have the old bartender. Discover new social. Adelaide has learnt a lot about vampires, and she can now share vampire knowledge with other Sims. Okay. We then have the bartender's wife. So, it looks like they're doing a meetup. That is Celine. She's the husband of this gentleman over here. That's a pair of Sims I made a while ago. Threw in to build up the society here in Newcrest. And we have Jeffrey. And we have Evelyn. Now, Evelyn is actually Celine and Alexander's daughter. She then has a daughter of her own, if I remember correctly. Well, it appears that Kat is not in the neighbourhood. So, and you've leveled up. So you can stop. You can... Oh, it's paused. Don't really want it paused. You can change. Don't really want to go out in that, especially seeing, I believe, your pointy ears show. So, the Spocky ears. So, let's choose the young. I believe she's here, yes. So, let's go. Drink plasma. Compel. I always go for... Ways move as bat. Let's quickly rush over again. Viola. Why is Viola everywhere? I mean, I have a strange feeling the fact that Viola's... That's Alexander wearing sunglasses. Okay. I have a feeling that Viola is trying to track down Adelaide, trying to see what she's doing. But at the moment, she hasn't seen Adelaide now, so she's just free. Viola doesn't know she's in Newcrest. But it's very dangerous. As is that. Now, you wanna come back in here? Ah, there's Kat. So, Kat's back. And Kat is reading a child's book. Because eventually, you just run out of things to read when you're in exile. So, let's not offer vampire training, but let's have a conversation. Share vampire knowledge. She knows everything. Meet another vampire. We can do that. Apparently, if a vampire doesn't want to consume the plasma of a Sim, they can consume plasma fruit or plasma packs. You already know that, Adelaide. Kat hasn't told you nothing new. Let's show off your powers, see how much you've done. Looks like Luella's suffering. She's trying to take care of herself, but she's suffering. looks as if they're getting there. Shudlara! Whoa. Cat just made a major mistake. That's embarrassing.
Girl Pando?
Buy a sword.
Samzo.
So it looks like they're having another training session. And then they can have a spa. I believe that's something you guys have been looking forward to see if Adelaide is good enough to outdo Cat. I mean, she may have taken down Marcos.
Uskinara.
The Davenport family are one of the weakest.
Fwibs Borb.
He is only a fletcher.
Crick Ribbo Glim. Uskinara. Grasha.
Her power's draining. So, let's have this spa.
Thana Wexa?
And then you can do...
Easy Wag!
Shupaza! Pues!
Alright, let's start a conversation, and then we'll go into... Damn it, Cat, where'd you go? Don't go, just do dark meditation for now. Where on earth did Cat go now? I'm sorry, but exile has made you lose social skills. I'm sorry, you don't just disappear on your apprentice like that in the middle of a training session. So, return back to reading more of that. You are currently level 7. Sim with a thirst for knowledge will sink their teeth into these books. Sims would be batty to pass up the helpful tips contained within. Vampire lore skill is improved by researching vampires on a computer or reading unlocked vampire tomes. In the description of that, there are so many vampire puns, it was no longer punny. I love a good pun, but not the cheesy ones. So, we looked at a few of them. Before, we had quite a few before. But Adelaide may just go back and look at a few at another point. She's nearly level 8. Unfortunately, they didn't get to spa. This passage says that enough garlic spread around the house can prevent a vampire from biting Sims. I assume because garlic drops vampire energy, and if the energy is too low they can't bite a Sim, I'm assuming? Because I know garlic in the vicinity leveled up, discovered new plants. Adelaide has learnt that there are some special ingredients that are used in some vampire specific recipes. She can now purchase plasma fruit, wolfsbane, and 6 some mosquito trap seeds. Okay, that could be very helpful. Yes, but I know garlic drops vampire energy, but I wouldn't have expected that a low level of vampire energy would prevent you from feeding. Vampire use vampire energy to perform power and protect themselves from harsh rays of sun. recover vampire energy by sleeping or using dark meditation. So, perhaps it does. Vampires don't get thirsty very often, but be sure to drink from sims or eat plasma fruit when they do, otherwise they may attack a nearby sim without warning. Adelaide read the talented vampires can turn other sims into vampires. A mortal sim can even ask a vampire to turn them, provided they know the vampire well enough. Okay, so I wonder if that also applies to whether or not they have the vampire creation. Because vampire creation allows them to turn them at the will of the vampire. If they ask to turn, I wonder if the vampire can then still do it. I don't know. Prime vampire. So, it appears Adelaide is almost halfway through proving herself. We shall see. Once Cat returns, they're then going to just spar just to do another test. But I believe Cat has something in particular planned for the next part. Now it's coming daytime, so soon enough Adelaide won't be able to go out in the dark. Adelaide read that there is a special drink concoction which can allow vampires to walk in the daylight for a limited time.
Aww.
Interesting. Adelaide may just need to use that. Oop, and it's like Cornelius isn't looking after himself either, because when seeing I'm away, he's not technically in hibernation, so his needs still drop. Oh look, both of them sorted there, then, okay. Discover plasma fruit recipe. Adelaide has learned that plasma fruit has some interesting uses in recipes. She can now prepare plasma fruit salad and the plasma Jane drink. Plasma Jane. I wonder if that has anything, any sort of connection to the Bloody Mary drink. Adelaide read that frogs are a valuable source for materials for creating your own plasma packs. We know. That is why Adelaide has her own frogs, which we're now going to breed. Ta-da. Unlocked Vampire Tome. Adelaide has exhausted all the information available in this book. If she wishes to continue her research, she should order Encyclopedia Vampirica Volume 3 on the computer under Vampire Secrets. Thankfully, we don't need to do this because Cat has a copy of her own. And seeing it's coming daytime, Adelaide, you are going to sleep in Cat's coffin until she returns. But that then is going to be it for this episode. Yes, I know most of my episodes go for about half an hour, especially gameplay, but this time I'm just going to cut it short because I have something in particular planned for the next part. So we are going to I'm just going to boost up the vampire energy, wait for Cat Cave to return, and then we'll see what news Cat Cave has to give to Adelaide to proceed with her plans. But I'm also not forgetting, Cat and Adelaide will have a spar to see how far Adelaide's coming in her training. Is she physically ready to move on? Or does she still need to do some more practicing? But in the next part, we shall see just what Cat has to give.